But there was helicopters around me and I was on the skyscraper. I was terrified.
So how did you get through that?
Like I get through anything. I figure it out.
I grew up in Scarborough. I dropped out of high school. Me and my friends, we just left home, man. We just started living the downtown life. I knew that I really wanted to be something. I just didn't know really what.
Some of you might know, some of you might not know, but I hadn't left Toronto for like 21 years, man. I stayed home. First time ever on a plane was like my first tour a couple years ago.
Do you think young Abel would believe you when you tell them where you'd be today?
I hope so. He was pretty hard-headed.
I mean, you've revealed this character to us over the past year. Can you tell me who this character is?
Honestly, I have my answers, but I love people's theories and conclusions on who he is and what it means and the message he's giving. Lamar Taylor, my best friend, I convinced him to drop out of high school with me. Now he's my creative director, and I hope there's no regrets at this point, so. Cash and Sal, my manager.
But I'm curious to know, what would you tell your 17-year-old self who left home, moved into a small apartment with a friend, you know? Eventually, that young Abel was going to become the Super Bowl halftime star. You've accomplished so much. What would you tell that kid?
Don't quit. Just don't quit.
I think we went on for about like almost a year with no pictures. Everyone's like, yo, who is this guy? Who's the Weeknd? How does he look?
Nobody has that mystique anymore. There's one person that does, and that's Abel. That's the Weeknd.
At the beginning of my career, because nobody knew how I looked as well. It was because of, you know, Daft Punk and a lot of artists that like to be enigmatic and mysterious. And fans didn't really see how I looked until my first show.
I want to thank my fans who've been with me from day one. EXO till we OD, so I love you guys very much. I wouldn't be here without you, and I think it's going to be a long-term relationship between me and you.
Rumor has it you invested quite a bit of your own money into the halftime show. Tell me, what does $7 million buy you at Raymond James Stadium?
Well, honestly, it was tough to bring the vision to life with what we had at the time. You know, we really wanted to be safe. We really thought about the players and the workers, so we built the stage within the actual stadium.
You donated meals to frontline workers. You've been honoring Black-owned restaurants. Can you talk a little bit about why that was important for you to do that?
I mean, I see that people are struggling, and I just want to help. I've been in that position myself, and I know what it feels like. You know, I never really had money growing up, so giving away isn't hard for me. It's very easy.
The downtown life, growing up in Scarborough with my mom, who I put through hell, but she's my biggest inspiration. Thank you, Mom. Appreciate it.